If the transformation from R2 to R3 is a linear transformation with t of -1, -1 equal to 2, -5, 2, and t of 1, -2 equal to 5, -2, 4, then what is the transformation of the vector -2, 1? Notice here we are not given the transformations of the standard basis vectors in R2 like we were in the previous example. So we're not going to find the transformation matrix. We will take a different approach this time. What we'll do is write the vector we want to find the transformation of, the vector -2, 1, as a linear combination of the vectors we know about, which are the vectors -1, -1, and 1, -2. So to set this up, we begin with the vector -2, 1 equal to C(1) times the vector -1, -1, plus C(2) times the vector 1, -2. And now we need to solve for C(1) and C(2). So we'll set up an augmented matrix. We'll notice how the first row is going to be -1, -1, -2, since the first equation would be -1 C(1) plus 1 C(2) equals -2. And the second row is -1, -2, 1, because the second equation is -1 C(1) minus 2 C(2) equals 1. So notice how we are changing the order of the equations to write the augmented matrix. The next step is to write the augmented matrix in reduced row echelon form, which I've already done. Notice how this indicates that C(1) equals 1 and C(2) equals -1. So now we can write the vector -2, 1 as a linear combination of the vectors we know about, which are the vectors -1, -1, and 1, -2. So now we know that the vector -2, 1 is equal to 1 times the vector -1, -1, plus -1 times the vector 1, -2. Next, we'll take the transformation of both sides of the equation. Remember, our goal here is to find the transformation of the vector -2, 1. On the right, we now have a transformation of the sum of these two products. But because we have a linear transformation, we can now rewrite the right side using the properties of linear transformations shown below. So we'll first write this transformation of a sum as a sum of two transformations, and then we'll also factor out the constants, which in this case are 1 and -1. So the right side, we now have 1 times the transformation of -1, -1, plus -1 times the transformation of the vector 1, -2. This is the form that we needed because we now know the transformation of the vector -1, -1, and the transformation of 1, -2 on the right side. So now I'll simply perform a substitution for these two transformations. Notice 1 times the transformation of the vector -1, -1 is just 2, -5, 2, and then plus -1 times the transformation of 1, -2 is just minus the transformation of the vector 1, -2, which is 5, -2, 4. And now to find the transformation of the vector -2, 1, we simply subtract the two vectors by subtracting the corresponding components. First we have 5 minus 2, which is -3, and then we have -5 minus -2, which is -3, and then finally we have 2 minus 4, which is -2. We now know the transformation of the vector -2, 1 is -3, -3, -2, which is what we were trying to find. I hope you found this helpful.